Hello everyone! In the previous video, we explored Evive's plug-and-play interface by performing some fun activities. In this video, we are going to have a look at the inbuilt tool that Evive has and that truly make it versatile and one of its kind. They are the pin state monitor, oscilloscope, sensing and function generator. Let's first have a look at the pin state monitor. Evive has 42 digital and 16 analog pins, out of which 0 to 27 digital pins, which can be found here, and A0 to A5 and A12 to A15 analog pins, which are located here, are available for users. Rest of them are used internally. You can find this information under the magic lid. You can monitor the live status of all these pins on Evive screen using the pin state monitor. Let's have a look how. Switch on Evive. From the menu, select Pin State Monitor using the navigation key. You will notice that there are three options. First is Digital Pin States. This option displays the status of only the digital pins. Their status can only be either a 0 or 1. Second is Analog Pin States, which displays the status of only the analog pins. Their value varies in the range of 0 to 1023. Third, Digital and Analog States, that displays the status of both digital and analog pins together. Time to see the pin state monitor in action. First, let's see what happens when we press tactile switch 1. This switch is internally connected to digital pin 38. The status of the pin will change to 1 on pressing this switch and return back to 0 as soon as we release it. Now, let's see what happens when we turn the potentiometer 1. It is connected to analog pin A9. As you turn the potentiometer, the value at that pin will vary between 0 to 1023. The pin state monitor is very useful to check input signals from various analog and digital sensors. Now, let's move on to the oscilloscope. The oscilloscope is an electronic lab equipment used to display and analyze various electronic signals. Evive has a mini oscilloscope of its own. Let's perform a small activity to see how the oscilloscope works. For this, take a DC motor with a wheel mounted on its shaft. Connect the motor wires to the middle and the rightmost pin of the graph port. Now, select Mini Oscilloscope from the menu. Rotate the motor manually with the help of the wheel. You will notice that spikes are generated as we rotate the wheel. How are these spikes generated? Here we are using the motor as a DC generator. When you rotate the wheel, voltage is generated, which can be observed on the oscilloscope in the form of spikes. Now, rotate the wheel in the opposite direction. You'll observe that this time the spikes are reversed. You can scale the graph, that is, change the value of each division using the navigation key. By pushing the navigation key up and down, you can change the voltage division. And by pushing it left and right, you can change the time division. The mini oscilloscope, as you can see, can really come handy when we need to study signals generated by any electronic component. Now, disconnect the motor and go back to the main menu by center pressing the navigation key. Time to move on to sensing. Many of you must be familiar with digital multimeter that is commonly used to measure voltage and current. Well, guess what? Evive can do a job of a multimeter as well. Let's perform a small activity for measuring the voltage of a AA battery. Take two male to female jumper cables and connect their female ends to the middle and the rightmost pin of the graph port. The center pin of the graph port is the ground pin. Therefore, connect the negative terminal of the battery to it. Connect the positive terminal of the battery to the rightmost pin. Now, select sensing from the menu. For measuring the voltage of the battery, select the first option. The voltage of the AA battery will be displayed under the probe V. This feature can be of great use for testing circuits. You can even use it for understanding the basics of electronics. Disconnect the wires and go back to the main menu. And now, let's have a look at Evive's function generator. A function generator, as the name suggests, is an instrument that generates function or electrical waveforms like the sine wave, square wave, triangular wave, etc. As you may have guessed by now, Evive has a function generator of its own that can generate various functions of desired frequency and amplitude. Let's have a look at how it works. Select beta function generator from the menu. A list will appear that shows the types of waveforms that function generator can generate. Let's work with the sine wave. Select it by pressing the navigation key to the right. You can control the amplitude of the wave between 0 to 2.5 volt using potentiometer 2 and the frequency in the range of 8.5 Hz to 500 Hz using potentiometer 1. Once you set the parameters, EVI will generate a sine wave corresponding to the amplitude and frequency set by you at the DAC port. Let's visualize it on the oscilloscope by using another EVI. Take two female-to-female jumper cables and connect one end of both the jumper cables to DAC port of the first EVI and the other ends to the middle and the rightmost pin of the graph port of the second EVI. And there you have it, the sine wave generated by the function generator being plotted on the mini oscilloscope. Notice that as you change the amplitude and frequency, the graph being plotted on the oscilloscope also changes in real time. Well, that's all for this video. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more such engaging videos, don't forget to subscribe to STEMpedia and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Bye for now.